Hi, I'm Diana Steinbach, International Vice President of ISSA, and I'm here with Andrea Deutschbein, Director of Soft Services for AMR Facility Management, and she's in charge of the Dubai Mall Soft Services Operations. And I believe, Andrea, you've been there for about 8 years out of your 25 years in the business, right?
Yes, Mike. Hi.
Thanks for being with us today. So you're the first mall in the world to be accredited with GBAC Star Facilities Accreditation. Can you share us just a little bit of the demographics about the facility? How big is the Dubai Mall for people who are not familiar?
Yes, well, we do have more than 190,000 square meter of floor area, which is just a common area. And more than 140 washrooms, for example, aside from escalator and more than 150 escalator. So it's quite a huge scale, and it's the biggest shopping mall in the world by area. So still, and we are very proud that we have passed the GBAC accreditation and specific as the first shopping mall in the world. Yeah,
That's
so
great.
we are welcoming every year around 85 million customers. So even during COVID, we had during the day almost 150,000. Yeah, almost 150,000 customers on a normal day.
Wow. And so when it comes to that many people coming through the mall, how important are your COVID infection prevention protocols to the business and your objectives there?
Well, as you can imagine, this is a high priority, and not just related in COVID in general. The hygiene and infection prevention is one of our most top priority, especially since we do have a lot of tourists coming to us, and a lot of tourists are there just for a day, so they come through transit, or they used to come through transit. This infection control is, or this GBAC accreditation is not just made for the pandemic, which we are going through at the moment. That is something we need in general, and even after COVID, so it's very important, because such things can happen anytime, and it's maybe not COVID, it's maybe a neurovirus or whatever, because we have cruise coming, so tourists from cruise ship. We have tourists coming through transit. They are just waiting for the next fly and passing by to the mall to see the Burj Khalifa, to see the Dubai Mall, and you never know where they came from and what they are carrying with them, and if they're only there for a few hours or one day, and something happened and they left already, so how will I research what is it happened? So I have to be prepared for this.
Sure, that makes
So.
perfect sense. And what helped you choose to pursue GBAC Star accreditation? I believe you had mentioned that you worked with your cleaning contractor on that.
Yeah, we work with our cleaning contractor who is already SIM certified. So this was a really advantage for us that he is aware about the regulation and the requirements in terms of ISS SIMs. And we had in general a very good hygiene concept already in state. However, this COVID, or no, those accreditation process showed us, even though you think you have a lot of SOPs already in place and you are perfect prepared, it still showed us the gap. And it forced us really to look into each and every document and review it and prepare it new as it should be. And the most different is, if you have as your operation the protocols in place and also the manuals in place, and you have all your checklist, and but it's always related to your operation itself. So it's you and your operator, your service provider. GBAC requires the attendance and the awareness of the entire building, whoever is in this building. So all the departments who are in the mall needs to be aware of our GBAC and the documents and the requirements, and need to be involved in this whole process. And this was really a challenge, because this was an eye-opening also for a lot of employees and staff who are working with us in other departments, because this gives them an insight what we're actually doing. It's not just cleaning,
Right. Well, right. There's so much more. It makes sense. And so what were there any special learnings that you came across when you were going through the process?
As I mentioned right now, the first learning was the involvement of all the other departments and getting them on board and, you know, convince them. And it's not just convincing, it's also a learning process. We did a lot of teaching, actually. So not only what is our job about, it's also why we do all those things. Why is it necessary? And believe it or not, there are still a lot of people, they don't understand why you should wash your hand permanently, you know, and when you after the washroom or even when you touch something, or why you should not touch always certain areas and certain surfaces. And there is still an unawareness around from a lot of people who don't see this or didn't see this necessary. It has been changed, the whole behavior of our staff, of our customer, of our employees has completely changed since we went to this GBAC accreditation. This is for sure, in a positive way.
Well, that's good to hear. So were there any ways for you to get feedback from your customers, either from the tenants or from the shoppers, to see what were their reactions to what you had done?
Yeah, so especially our tenants, for example, they have never been involved, although we have never looked into our tenants before, so how they maintain actually their own area, because our contract is the common area and this is, you know. So we never really looked into our tenants, and it had us realize that, because we did know the inspection, we had to involve them, that a lot of tenants are damaging or get their service damaged because of the wrong maintenance. They're also using either other service provider. And then, you know, more than 1,600 tenants and everyone has his own service provider, then you realize also how many different companies are actually there. And they all have different equipment and they all have different chemicals. And not everyone is applying on the, you know, on the health and safety requirements. And if it's just how they use the chemicals and filling it up in a water bottle, for example. This is a very simple but very common example on this time. So we've been able to do this training and do this process really to enhance the standard also from our tenant, you know, from their service provider, from their cleaning part, and realizing them or make them realize how important the right methodology is in cleaning in terms of saving and maintaining your surfaces and enhance the life cycle of the surfaces. It's not just hygiene, it's also, you know, the real FM component on this. And this came through all this process and it was an eye opening from them. And I had several training sessions actually with our tenants to explain what is the requirement from the pandemic, for example, what should be on place, as well the general requirements in terms of cleaning and hygiene.
Yeah. Sure, and so now that you've had some time to go through the processes and institutionalize that, do you and Farnak go through and do any kind of auditing or checkups to see how things continue to happen?
We do have our own audits, of course, permanent. So there are minimum 4 audits per day per shift. And we are on 3 shifts, so this is a lot of audits, but this is a huge area also, don't forget to reach there. So that's our own audits. The washroom's been audited every hour, but we do also have our smart washrooms, which is helping us, so because we can monitor the footfall in our washrooms. And if you consider that we have even now during the pandemic with a lower footfall than usual, almost 3,000 customers per day in each washroom, so this is our average customer per day, then you really see the importance of hygiene standards as well of auditing. And we do have municipality auditor. So the municipality inspections are here every day and without pre-announcement, so I never know when they are coming and which area they're going to check. And just because we do have all our documents ready and have the evidence there, this is helping a lot. And in addition to the recognition, we do have almost no complaint from customer in terms of hygiene. I mean, you've never been without any complaint. This is always something, but because it's opinion, but it's more related to maybe, you know, there was a queue, I had to stay too long, or maybe there is, maybe the smell was not present, which can happen when you have so many customers at the same time there. Or maybe there's not enough sitting area, which is just related to the new requirements on COVID-19, that you should not have so many sitting and then people not placed together. But it's not in terms of cleaning, and we are very proud of it. And in fact, we just recently, last week, received the Clean Middle East Hygiene and FM Award for the best maintained washrooms, which is amazing, because this is not the best maintained washroom from shopping malls or from Dubai. It is from the Middle East. So we are really, really proud of it.
Oh, congratulations. Thank well, it's a sign of your commitment to the excellence that you have there. Well, you know, and here's a question. You have done so much already in your operations and with your contractor to ensure that you have a high level of quality. So why was it important to go to an outside accreditation when you really do have a strong program? What was the value of bringing that in?
The most value brought in was because this accreditation is something which is recognized also from customer and from any other third party, any other stakeholder, any other, you know, outsider who is not involved in our business. So we know what we do. And sometimes you just sell yourself enough because you see this as a common thing. This is your job. This is what you get paid for. And this is what you want to do. And this is your commitment. So this is what we're doing. But now with this accreditation, this is something very public and everybody can see this. It's a certificate. And this is also a selling point for tourists or customer to feel safe and say, oh, they went through all this, they have the certification, we can go in this facility, this is safe for us. And specific for the last couple of months after the reopening, where we really needed each and every customer, as you can imagine, it was very, very important for us. And by the way, the award, one of the criteria to receive the award was also the GPAC accreditation. This is, of course, a very high value on this.
Yeah. Sure.
It's a proof that we're doing our job.
That makes sense. So speaking of the activities since you were accredited, can you tell us a little about some of the events that you've had? What's the footfall been in the mall over time? Because I think you've even opened a new wing. So it seems like you've had a lot of growth since then.
We open new wings. We have even new businesses. We have a lot of new shops opening during the last couple of months. So there is new businesses coming. Tenants are renovating and reopening. And we have been last year, summertime, where no tourists actually been there because it was a lockdown from tourism. We had the most busiest time in the mall with our local citizens and local people because they couldn't go out. So they needed a place to go to. And they came to us because we've been accredited and we've been safe and they feel safe. And we had actually also really questioned, what is this GBAC? But because we announced it, so why you have this, what is it, and what does it mean for me? So and this was one point why they really came. Yeah, and yes, we opened during COVID a new wing, the Fountain View, with another 75,000 square meter of common area. We just opened last week in one of our entities, a very nice even in your place, knowing a restaurant, the Time Out Market, which is the first one of this kind in the Middle East. And it's, as I said, our daily footfall is 150,000 still. And 3,000 in the washrooms. This is what I can say because they have the counting on it. So we had, it's not only that we are being busy, but we also have the challenge as every other business that the budget is cut. So you have actually to do a lot of more requirements when it comes to disinfection, when it comes to hygiene, but with a less amount of money available. And this GPAC accreditation helped us a lot on this because it was also, you know, a part of becoming more effective and really looking into the areas, what is necessary to do, what is not necessary to do, where we can maybe extend frequency and what is very important you have to do. So we could set priorities for different tasks. And being in line with the requirements from GPAC from the GPAC, and this it helped us a lot being effective.
Interesting. And so, have you had any cases since you've been accredited, or where? Because I know it's not like when you're accredited, nothing can come into the building, but you're prepared for it. So, have you had any cases with employees or tenants?
Exactly. So we do have maintenance cases, so that maybe one because you know you need to understand that the third person in this tenant area, they are also living maybe with sharing rooms or whatever there. So also they have their families. I mean, so they're using public transportation. So that's always a contact point where you can detect this the COVID. And we did have positive cases, but because of the policies in place, which is part of the GPAC, we could act immediate and everybody did know what needs to be done. So it has never been affected the customer, it has never affected the business. The protocol been in place and has been followed. And of course we had our disinfection and we never had a single case in our office. And we are a huge office, and it's not just the that we didn't have a positive case. Nobody gets sick anymore because of all the precaution you do, and this is something you really can realize. Yeah, so it's you know, when we have those weather change from hot to cold or from cold to hot, which is happening usually in our region, just from one day to the other, and then you have from 15 degree cold, all of the sudden the next day is 30 degree or 31 degree hot. So this is the area, and you still are in the AC area, so we are always having the running. So this is normally a time where people are getting sick and touching, but because of this disinfection program, because of the mask, because of all this distancing, you don't get sick people anymore. So it's not just about COVID.
So there's higher productivity. This goes straight to the value of cleaning, right? Like all of these protocols are helping people be more productive and healthier, right?
Exactly.
Oh, that's great to hear.
It's not just about COVID. It is in general enhance the standard of hygiene, having the right protocols in place, have all the SOPs in place, the methodology in place, the awareness, which is very, very important for everyone, not just you and your team. And also, you know, we are very open to our customer when disinfection has been in place and when the checklist is available for everyone can be seen. So when was the last check on our washroom, for example? When was the last disinfection on the washroom? When was the last disinfection on the prayer room? And everyone can see it. So we are very open on it.
Interesting. And so do you have any advice for anyone else who's considering going through the accreditation or who's in the process? Any advice you have for what can help them?
What can help them? Very important to be open and really have everyone involved of your entity. So everyone, not just the FM department or cleaning department. It is a process where everyone in your building has to go through and has to have an understanding on. So it's very important that you get them on board Because otherwise your protocols will not help. If you have all, you know, then it's just a piece of paper. So you have all the documents, of course, you may be clean, but if all the other elements around not being followed by the other stakeholder, then you will not pass, you will not go through, and you will not be successful. So this is one thing you really have to consider. And yeah, take the help from ISA also, because it was very helpful to get your mentoring and advices and before you go to the application. Yeah, do you have attend your meeting, your training, for example. This is also very helpful, and it is for everyone. It's the easy way, and specific now with all this technology in place, where you can just do it to Teams or to video call. Use it and train your people. It's the best way to do so and get awareness.
Great. Well, thanks so much. Any last comments you have about the situation in the Dubai Mall?
Well, the Dubai Mall is in a good shape, I would say. We are having business as usual, and it's like almost a normal life. We're getting very much used to the mask, and this is the only thing which remembers us really on the COVID situation. Otherwise, it is a normal life, and we are very proud of this and very happy about it. And please visit us if you can.
Well, that's great, and it seems like you guys are one of the first places where visitors can come during the pandemic wind down, right?
Yes, it is like, and you know, we have this beautiful fountain to see. We have this aquarium where the entrance to the Burj Khalifa, the biggest tower in the world. So it is always a good point to come and a place to visit to us. And yeah, please.
That's great. Well, thanks again, Andrea, for your input and your insights. And we're very happy that you're pleased with the process and that it's been effective for you.
Yes, it is. Yes. Thank you so much for the help.